finally, The Rock has come back to Houston! And finally, all the games are over because once again, finally, The Rock is the WWF Champion! Vince McMahon, you still have a lot to be thankful for. You're still the owner of this multi-million dollar company. You are still the owner of a beautiful house. You're still the owner of luxurious cars. And you're still the owner of the best penis implant money can buy.
What? I didn't know that. What the? He can't say that, can he?
But even after last night, Vince, as we stood in the middle of the ring and The Rock put his foot on your chest, it became crystal clear that The Rock owns the WWF title and The Rock also owns your candy ass.
I think Mr. McMahon may have something to say about this.
Perhaps.
The Rock realizes, Vince, you're not going to take this lying down. Because it wouldn't be a Monday Night Raw if you didn't come out here and run your mouth at The Rock. So The Rock says this, just bring it, because the McMahon-Helmsley faction is over and The Rock's era has just begun.
Is he inviting Mr. McMahon out here?
Well, it sure sounds that way, doesn't it?
Uh-oh.
Everything under control.
First of all, allow me to congratulate you on once again becoming World Wrestling Federation champion.
Now that's mighty big of Mr. McMahon, you gotta admit.
Furthermore, allow me to wish you good luck in the new Rock era.
That's even bigger.
Why would a man like me say something like that? I'll tell you. That's not the reason.
No, it's certainly not.
That's not the reason at all. Because last night at the King of the Ring, as I lay on my back in the middle of the ring, looking up at the lights of the Fleet Center, the pain and discomfort of the rock bottom finally relinquishing its grip on me, it was there last night that I had an epiphany. It was there last night, and that flash of clarity, I knew all about the questions. Questions about my wife, Linda.
Uh-oh.
Why? And that one moment, why would my wife have been so kind to so many of my adversaries? Why would my wife make business decisions that she knew I wouldn't like? Why would my wife have the temerity to stand up face to face to me, risking the wrath of my retribution? Why? Why, Linda, why? And then it dawned on me in that moment, there could only be one reason why she would do all those things and say all those things. And it's simply because she loves me.
What? She loves him. That's some tough love.
There can be no other reason. And Linda, I love you too. And I'm about to tell you just how much I love you. You see, because Linda, I know that you've been clamoring, almost figuratively begging for my attention, my adoration. And Linda, upon reflection, I'm going to give you exactly what you want. Because from this moment on, Linda, your life is going to change for the better, and so is mine. Because from now on, no matter how much attention you want, you're going to get it from me.
What?
No matter how much love, no matter what kind of love, whether or not it's tenderly touching, whether it's rough or ready, it doesn't matter to me, Linda.
Rough or ready?
No. You're going to get all the love you can handle and then some.
What about the business, Vince? What? The WWF? What? What's he doing?
Because, Linda, something else has dawned on me, and that is I have a hunch that not only do you want the adoration, not only do you want my love and affection, but you want the fruits of my love and affection. I have a hunch, Linda, that what you want is another baby.
Another baby?
Man.
And Linda, if you want another baby, I'm your genetic jackhammer.
What? Oh my gosh, another little Shane or Stephanie running around?
Genetic jackhammer.
Linda, daddy's coming home.
Oh, the jackhammer.
Man, I don't think I've ever seen or
and Rock,
Mr. McMahon quite like this.
Just to show you I meant every word I said, I'd like to let bygones be bygones. If you're the man I think you are, you'll shake my hand.
Be a man.
Mr. McMahon extending the olive branch to the new WWF champion.
Right.
At least that's how it seems. I gotta admit, Vince was very sincere in his remarks about his wife.
This is touching.
The Rock's smiling.
Vince told The Rock he's a hell of a guy.
Uh-oh.
Rock, let him go. He's got business to take care of. Jackhammer.
Now, before you go home and make babies with Linda.
Yeah, yeah.
Rock just has a couple of things to say. You are still Vince McMahon, the owner of this multi-million dollar company. And you may be a stud in bed.
Jackhammer.
But The Rock just wants you to know one thing. As far as for The Rock is concerned, you are now and will forever be an asshole.
Brace on his right arm. You've seen that huge bruise in the past, courtesy of Chris Benoit.
Oh, look out. Pulling out the 24th pass. Oh, my God.
After all the history that you and The Rock have been through, after all the cage matches, the ladder matches, I quit matches, last man standing matches, The Rock says, welcome back.
What? Welcome back?
All right.
Oh, please.
A lot of respect between those two men, King.
Where's the affection when you need it?
Thank you, Rock. And let me congratulate you now, five-time WWF champion.
And he's only 28 years of age.
This is getting a little sickening, the Mutual Admiration Society.
And not only that, but I've got to say, Rock, that has got to put you right up there in the elite list of the greatest WWF champions of all time.
Oh, boy. I think I'm getting sugar diabetes.
And I want to know one thing. How does that make you feel?
What do you think?
Well, the Rock.
It doesn't matter how it makes you feel.
Okay, that was good. I'll give it to you.
Foley.
That was a good one. I gotta give him credit.
Our commissioner even made the Rock smile.
I finally got you.
You think that happens in the White House or only in the WWF? I think the latter.
Well, Foley will never be nicknamed Dumbo, but he did crack a good joke.
Didn't The Rock tell you never to use his catchphrases again?
Yeah, I remember that.
Listen, the fact of the matter is this. There's business to tend to. Why all the deliberation about the number one contendership? You are the commissioner of the WWF. The Rock says, just make a new number one contender.
The Rock is ready for action and...
anymore. No, tonight I'm taking a stand. Tonight, just as my forefathers did, Shane McMahon is declaring his Independence Day.
All right.
You see, it should be me. It should be Shane O'Mac, who takes the World Wrestling Federation into the next millennium. And it should be me, Shane McMahon, who deems and who decides who should be the number one contender.
Yes! That's good enough for me, Dare. Well, I don't know that it's going to be good enough for the...
Wait, Shane. It was kind of hard for me to tell with all these people screaming at you, but are you saying that you think you should be the number one contender?
No. I'm not saying that.
You should name the number one contender, you idiot.
Wait, Rock.
I think that's what he inferred, wasn't he? No. You sure?
Rock, did you hear Shane O'Mac say that he should be the number one contender?
That's not what I said!
No!
I didn't say that!
He didn't say that, JR.
It sounds to The Rock that Shane wants to be the number one contender.
I think you're right, Rock. I think Shane does want to be the number one contender.
Shane.
No.
Shane, when you were talking about sailing 15 feet through the air and down crashing through the table, I've got to admit, I went home and I put that tape on freeze frame and I put it on slow motion and I looked real carefully. And as you were sailing 15 feet through the air, I saw it, Shane!
What?
You had something that I used to, actually The Rock used to call it, and I stole it from him, but it's called testicular fortitude.
Grapefruits, baby!
And you, my friend, have got it.
No doubt about it.
So Kate, I'm telling everybody right here in Orlando, Florida.
That works every time.
That we've got ourselves a new number one contender.
What? Wait a minute. Oh, my. No.
And what the hell, Rock? You look ready for a fight? We're going to make the match right here tonight in this very ring.
No, wait a minute. You know what The Rock will do to Shane? You can't. He's hurt. Crippled. Well, you might be
so
right.
Basically, Shane McMahon, what Commissioner Foley has just said is you come out here and you run your mouth about your Independence Day. You come out here, run your mouth, 4th of July, 1776, and you run your mouth about your forefathers. Well, The Rock says this, the year 2000. And just like The Rock's forefathers, George Washington, he cannot tell a lie, because The Rock says tonight he's just going to kick your candy ass all over Orlando.
Shane McMahon and The Rock.
Not fair.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine?
Did you smell what The Rock is cooking?
Once again, folks.
Shane McMahon came here tonight in no shape for a title match. Injured ribs, bum knee. He wants sympathy. Will you show it to him?
Will The Rock show Shane McMahon sympathy? Did Shane McMahon show The Rock sympathy in all those handicap matches? Did he show The Rock sympathy in all those BS matches? Did Shane ever show The Rock sympathy in time after time? He let The Rock laying in a pool of his own blood? So you ask The Rock, is he gonna show Shane sympathy? You're damn right he will. Because The Rock feels very sorry for Shane McMahon. Sorry to know that Shane is gonna walk out of Orlando with The Rock's boot turned sideways, shoved right up his candy ass.
Oh my God.
Now you know that I'm not at 100%. That my ribs are cracked. I got a hyperextended knee. And being that I'm not 100% Rock, I know you don't want to take advantage of that. Because if Shane O'Mac was 100%, then Shane McMahon would walk out of Orlando the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
Whoa.
But.
That's true. It's true.
Rock, hear me out for a second. This is the whole point. You and I should not be fighting. No. Rock, you and I should be allies.
Allies?
Think about it, Rock. The old man's lost it. He's history.
Huh?
My mom, she's enthralled with power. She's gone. Steph and Triple H, no offense, they've blown it. But you and I, Rock, think about it. you could be World Wrestling Federation champion forever.
He's got a point.
Unite with me, Rock. We can build the strongest force that the WWF has ever known. What do you say?
What do you think, JR?
Rocky.
I don't. It sounds pretty
That's
impressive.
Right. Listen to him. Do you smell what I'm cooking?
Did he say unite?
Yes,
did Shane McMahon say Rock unite
me and you.
With Shane?
Me and you. That's it. That's it.
Oh, they're trying to jump him from behind. And look at Benoit. He just still served the slaughter. And right back on the crossbar.
Gosh.
Benoit. He is rabid. Benoit snapped here.
Rock is helpless. He can't do anything.
And a Benoit, my God. He's going to rip the Rock apart.
Look at Shane getting a shot in.
Shane McMahon with a steel chair. Well, Rock helpless. The Rock. You can hear the Rock. God almighty, how is he even conscious? Benoit is continuing to rip and tear.
I'm telling you, this is bad. Rock may not be conscious.
With a steel chair.
God.
My God, we've got to have some help. Look at Shane from the chair to the shoulder of the Rock.
I think the Rock is completely out.
Oh, the Rock is, he's going to be out. The Rock is hurt. My God, here comes Mick Foley. The commissioner.
Watch it, watch it.
Mick Foley coming to the ring, but the Rock has been punished. The Rock has been tortured. The Rock has been hit the crossface longer than any human being ever. Thank God the commissioner was here. Thank God Mick Foley was able.
Yeah, but you got to know that this is not what Mick Foley had in mind when he made this match. The Rock is wasted.
And then Shane McMahon, what do we have here? Little Benoit smiling.
Chris, let me speak first. I want to make you aware, because I'm not sure that you know how Chyna spent the 3 hours before Raw, are you? Well, I'm going to tell you how. She spent 3 hours before Raw with my six-year-old little girl, doing her hair, putting on makeup, playing with little dolls. I genuinely like Chyna. Not because she's the ninth wonder of the world, but because she's a good person, because she's a funny person, and because she's my friend.
I don't think Benoit cares.
And then, Chris, you did this to her. Take a look. Take a look, Chris, because you did this.
This was this past Monday on Raw, King.
Chyna comes from behind. And I know you felt it, didn't you, Chris? Now she's down. Now she's down. And what do? You do what you always do. You take advantage. Down goes Eddie Guerrero. And now you take a helpless woman and you torture her. She went from playing with my little girl to having her neck stretched, her shoulder torn. And I'm telling you right now, as we stand here in this ring, Chris, with that sick little smile on your face, I'm telling you, Chris, that you make me sick. So if you've got an explanation, I'd like to hear it. I guess not. So then let's take a look at your little fun later on in the show after I've booked a tremendous main event. Let's take another look. Here's The Rock laying the smack down. He's got him dead to rights, people's elbow, and from behind. Not like a man, Chris, but from behind. Time and again, as hard as you could, you brought it down upon The Rock. And then when he lays helpless, once again, the crippler crossbaces your little buddy Winkton, lays in some boots. And you're proud of yourself, aren't you, Chris? And the same sick little smile. And I look at you, Benoit, as I stand here face to face. And you know what I see? I see one of the damn best wrestlers I've ever seen in my entire life. But there are certain things, Chris Benoit, that I do not see when I look at those dead eyes. I do not see an ounce of remorse. I do not see compassion. And I sure as hell don't see a sense of humor.
So Chris Benoit, I think I speak for everybody when I ask this one simple question. Why? Why, Chris, why? I want to know. You don't see any remorse.
I wouldn't push Benoit if I were these people.
You don't see any remorse because I don't have any.
Wow.
You don't see any compassion because I have none. I don't need a sense of humor. I sure as hell don't have to explain myself to you or anyone else. I'm the greatest technical wrestler in the world today, as well as the greatest technical wrestler in the history of the WWF. That is the way it is. Prove me wrong. And if you don't like it, that's just too damn bad. You see, I have only one thing on my mind right now, and that's WWF gold. And I'll go through anyone or anything that stands in my way. If you really want to find out why I did what I did, I suggest you put me in a title fight tonight against the man who calls himself the People's Champion.
Benoit wants to rock tonight!
Against the man who calls himself the WWF Champion. Against the man who calls himself The Rock.
Can you believe it, King?
Yeah, I can believe it!
And my actions will speak louder than words.
Oh, I'd love to see that.
So you want a piece of The Rock, huh?
He wants a piece of The Rock, all right.
Well, let me tell you what, Benoit. You are damn good, that's for sure. And I'm going to think real hard about your little request, and we'll see what comes out. How does that sound?
Rock, after Monday night, which had to seem like one of the longest nights of your life, tonight, yourself, Eddie Guerrero and Chyna get a shot at Edge and Christian, and of course, Chris Benoit.
Finally, The Rock has come back! Home. No, Chris Benoit, last Monday night when you hit The Rock in the back with a chair, when you locked in the crippler crossface and wouldn't let it go, you thought you stepped into the plate. You thought you stepped into the big leagues. But the fact of the matter is this, Chris Benoit, is you have no idea of the world you stepped into. You see, Benoit, you run your mouth about how you're a great wrestler. Well, trust The Rock, tonight, if The Rock gets a hold of you, no, when The Rock gets a hold of you, he's not gonna put you in an arm bar, a candy bar, a monkey bar, a topless bar. Oh, it doesn't matter what type of bar it is. You see, Chris Benoit, you run your mouth about how you are the greatest technical wrestler in the history of the WWF. Well, technically, you more than get the job done. Technically, the crippler crossface hurts like hell. But after tonight, when it's all said and done, technically, The Rock is just gonna whip your candy all over Fort Lauderdale.
Trying to watch in this match. No, we're gonna get the evil killer. Wait, right hand to Benoit.
the triple across face, locked in again to Chyna. Chris Benoit, China's writhing in pain.
How come that Benoit would do this if he had a chance?
This is sick. This is sadistic. I think I can actually hear Chyna shouting, ripping right out of place.
Rock's going after Shane.
Shane back.
Shane back into the ring.
And out the Rock's back too, guys.
And the Rock with Christian. But Benoit still has the cross face on Chyna.
Myself, the man leading the WWF into this next millennium.
He's reading your mind, JR.
And Chris Benoit, the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
Well, that's a pretty bold statement, wouldn't you say? The Rock is the WWF champion.
It's actually quite easy. Chris Benoit and I are just friends.
Just friends, there it is.
Friends.
You see, I've always respected Chris Benoit, but as of late, I've quickly grown to admire everything that Chris Benoit stands for.
Cold-hearted, calculating, uncaring. He's a machine, it's Benoit.
Right, come as they come.
Say what you want about me. Well, let's continue to talk about the man, Chris Benoit. You see, Chris Benoit is a man that is goal-oriented. Chris Benoit is a man with deadly focus. Chris Benoit is a man that is cold-hearted. Chris Benoit is a man that is absolutely ruthless.
And he's damn proud of it, JR.
Everything Shane McMahon said
is true. Chris Benoit
is
a man
right. That
just so happens to be an equal opportunity offender. But just don't take my word for it, no. Allow me the pleasure of diverting your attention to the Titantron. And let's go back to last Monday night, and let's show you all what I'm talking about. Oh, there it is. Oh, Chyna, yo quiero aspirin. Oh my God, then from there, right there, Benoit, yeah.
Keep down on Chyna, the triple cross face. That's what I'm talking about, Chris. Now you cinch that bad boy on, and you just hold it and let her scream.
Equal opportunity.
But I was amazed. I thought I admired Chris Benoit for taking out Eddie and Chyna, but no. Much to my chagrin, I was even more surprised, even more baffled, when Chris Benoit, later on that night, laid the SmackDown on the People's Champ. Let's take a look at that.
Oh, man, he did
there
that.
There it is.
Too.
I'm about to turn the tide on the Rock, and wham!
From behind.
Benoit, yeah, bam! Again, I can't see that enough. And there it is, Rocky. That's it, Rocky. Cry. Cry, Rocky. Cry at the hands of Benoit. That's it. There's no hope for you. No, none.
The Rock was crying.
I don't think so.
Well, you see,
Benoit likes this. How cold and premeditated is Chris Benoit?
Listen to these people. They want the Rock.
Now, quite frankly, Chris, I don't blame the Rock from ducking you.
What?
Matter of fact, that's exactly what Rock has been doing. Rock doesn't want to be put in a grip lacrosse face. Case in point, let's go back to last Thursday night. Let's take a look at SmackDown. When, yes, right there, Rock. The Rock conveniently uses myself, yours truly, as an excuse to run away from Chris Benoit. Rock is running away from Chris Benoit. And the end result, yes, Chyna once again provokes Benoit, and the end result is the crippler crossface.
Once again, equal opportunity.
Sick, that's all I got to say about him. Sick.
I stand before all of you, and I stand next to a man in this very ring that I am proud to call my friend. You're the man.
Friends, true friendship.
Yeah, real friends, huh?
Thank you, Shane. I'm equally proud to call you my friend.
What you guys just hug?
However, The Rock is certainly no friend of mine.
You see, I don't have friends who are cowards.
Cowards?
What?
Whoa. I don't have friends who like to hide behind women's skirts. And I certainly do not have friends who cannot admit that I am the world's greatest technical wrestler in the history of the WWF.
You know, that's true. It's true. Well, that's an arguable point, I suppose.
That's why tonight, I'm asking The Rock to prove me wrong.
What do you mean by that?
Well, don't worry, Rock. I'm not going to ask you to put up the title tonight. But if I beat you, and I will, then I want you one-on-one in a title match at Fully Loaded, where I will become WWF champion, and that is the way it is.
Sounds like Benoit. He's challenging The Rock here tonight for a non-title shot. That's what it sounds like to me.
Oh, and by the way, Commissioner Foley isn't here to make the match tonight. He's on a PR tour of Southeast Asia.
That's true.
And as far as I'm concerned, I hope the commissioner comes down with a case of dysentery. That way, he'll be able to talk out of both ends at the same time, just like The Rock.
Whoa! Dysentery!
If you smell!
The Rock has ever backed down from. And that covers a heck of a lot of ground.
Chris Benoit, you come out here and you run your mouth. And you actually have the nerve to ask The Rock prove you wrong.
That's what he said.
Well, The Rock has no problem proving you wrong, because if you think, Benoit, that you're better than The Rock, you're wrong. And if you think that Shane McMahon is anything more than a silver spoon, puppy cheek, punk-ass son of a bitch, you're wrong.
Oh, my God.
And if you think after hearing your challenge that later on tonight that The Rock isn't going to walk down this ramp, get in that ring and whip your candy ass all over San Jose,
of the champion,
then you're wrong, Benoit, because The Rock says this to you and you: just bring it, jabronis, just bring it.
So the Rock, he's accepted the challenge. It's gonna be The Rock and Chris Benoit right here tonight. Can you believe that? What a matchup. The Wolverine and the WWF champion will go one-on-one right here tonight.
Oh, man, what a night is this gonna be, JR?
The Rock and Benoit, a main event of epic proportions.
Hey, what is this?
And Chyna and Eddie Guerrero, they've got tears.
What the heck?
Chyna Guerrero coming for Benoit and Shane McMahon.
It was an ambush. It was a mugging.
Mamacita.
And we are ready to go. Shane McMahon, Benoit's friend, up on the ring apron, posing a distraction, and here comes Benoit, trying to get the jump on The Rock, but to no avail. The Rock and Chris Benoit, what a main event, and you're seeing it live here tonight on Raw. Benoit, the
We call him the Rabid Wolverine because he is as deadly as any animal in the game. And a power slam by The Rock. The leg is stitched up, and we got two, a long, full two count.
And Benoit calls himself the best technical wrestler in the entire world today.
And he may be. I can't argue that point.
He wants to prove it to The Rock.
He certainly may be. Benoit's a magnificent, extraordinary athlete. And there's a suplex right on The Rock's head. Benoit using that leverage and technique to get underneath
Watch
The Rock.
It. Triple across face. Oh.
We saw Benoit uncaring, cold, a callous human being. Not once, but twice. The triple cross face to Chyna last week.
And look at him go right here. He is rabid. All this misses the phone, but on the mat.
Oh. Beautiful suplex. He got here. Man, that was close.
Look at Shane. What is Shane doing? Shane is so excited.
By Benoit. Unbelievable impact, those chops. And now downstairs, to the heart, to the solar plexus. Benoit is all over The Rock in a snap suplex.
Come on, JR, you got to be impressed with
cover.
Benoit.
I am impressed. There's a cover.
I mean, I like The Rock as well as the next guy, but Benoit, I mean, he's got something special.
Now, both these men are young, and they're special here in the WWF. Benoit again. That just hurts. All the way down to your toes. Another one. The Rock right down that bottom turnbuckle. And Benoit with everything he's got, bringing it to the champion. And The Rock has had enough. Right hands from the WWF champion. And he just made the SmackDown on the Wolverine. Oh. Man, what a war this is. What a rivalry this is. It's developing into.
Uh-oh, look at this.
And another suplex. And Benoit holding on.
And we've seen it before.
Another suplex. That's two.
That's not enough. We're going to take more damage.
That's another one. The Rock's trying to fight out. Benoit, he can't. But Rock trying to block the third suplex. And the Rock counters with a suplex of his own. Much to the chagrin of Benoit's friend, Shane McMahon.
Yeah, it looks like a little bit of
this bully loader could be a huge matchup. If the WWF title is on the line, it's Benoit's to win here. The Rock and Benoit both down.
Shane.
Folks, we don't have an update on Chris Jericho. There's a cover. But we'll try to. We don't have a bug off the air. We'll have it certainly Thursday night on SmackDown.
I'll tell you one thing that doesn't bode well for The Rock. That idiot right there, Earl Hebner. The Hebnerite's in there. How's that always happen?
Yes, he's a top official.
Oh, no, you almost said it. Go ahead, ask the commissioner. That's how it happens. Mick Foley.
I'm fighting back with a good right hand. Benoit, no, he was in trouble, but he reverses it. But he misses it. The clothesline. And the Rock, DDT. DDT with The Rock. He's on the left hook. That should be all. That should be all. And Benoit, he kicked out. I don't know how he did it, but that Benoit reaches down and kicked out. Benoit is an amazing specimen. You've got to be impressed with Chris Benoit.
Uh-oh.
Lucky or not, spinebuster by The Rock.
That was impressive. Uh-oh. Look at that.
What the hell is going on? Shane McMahon just... Wait a minute. Shane McMahon gets a stop to the referee. Well, this is not fair. Shane McMahon right back into the ring where the Wolverine is left. And down goes The Rock with a clothesline.
Right.
And a triple crossface.
He's got it hooked in.
Benoit's got the crossface on The Rock.
He's got it locked in. This is it. The Rock's finished.
You can almost hear The Rock's neck and shoulder tearing. The torque. Look at the strain of Benoit's face. Benoit's face tells the story as The Rock is writhing in pain.
He's trying to make it to the ropes.
The Rock is riding in pain. The Rock's trying to get Tap out. Tap out.
Look at the Rock.
The Rock
still
was reaching for
there.
The rope. Come on. Let go of the hole.
Feel that, Rock. You feel it.
The Rock's going to be.
Feel it.
He's been ripped and torn apart by the crook of the crossface.
Yeah, but Benoit's been declared the winner by Shane McMahon.
Oh, that's a bunch of crap. Benoit with that crossface on the Rock.
Let's see this again. What? Rock is reaching for the rope.
Exactly.
Oh, wait. There is a
that's
tap.
Not a tap.
No, wait. Does he tap?
He did tap. Out.
Look at he's tapping his hand.
You're the craziest. You're insane.
What the?
The Rock riding in pain. Benoit with a prick of the crossface has asserted himself on the Rock as no one ever has before. They're friends. Shane and Benoit, friends. My big Oklahoma.
Ladies and gentlemen,
come on,
the referee Earl Hebner has informed me that due to outside interference,
what?
The winner of this match on disqualification is the Rock.
What?
Had the reverse of the decision.
What?
Had the reverse of the decision.
Shane's the referee.
That's the right call. Shane's not the referee, damn it. Shane's Benoit's friend and friendship referee other friends' matches.
Yeah, but Earl Hebner was at. Uh-oh, look at this. Now you've done it, Hebner.
Now, what's Benoit going to pick on Earl Hebner? That's a tough guy.
Uh-oh.
Now, Mr. Wolverine picked on the referee.
And again,
the Rock's up. The Rock is up.
Look at this.
The Rock is trying to get to Benoit.
Shane McMahon.
I thought it is a friendship.
You can't understand it because you don't have any friends.
And Eddie Guerrero whipped into the corner by Chris Benoit. Meticulous.
Ooh.
And a chop echoing throughout the Oakland arena. Listen to this.
Ooh.
Yeah. And Eddie Guerrero down to his knees.
We're seeing the European champion Eddie Guerrero against the future WWF champion, the rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit.
Eddie Guerrero into the turnbuckle. And Benoit is picking apart the European champion.
I'm afraid these people can chant Eddie all they want to. Or maybe even some Latino heat.
And Eddie Guerrero trying to get in the middle. Off the second rope. Tornado DDT. Benoit's in trouble as Chyna tears Eddie Guerrero on. What action here on SmackDown tonight. Still to come. Triple H and The Undertaker. No disqualification. What chops by Eddie Guerrero.
I'll tell you what. I'm sure that Shane McMahon is concerned for his friend right now.
Tilt him off into a backbreaker by Chris Benoit.
Oh, look at Benoit. And
Benoit says that's it.
And when Benoit says that's it, you can take it to the bank.
Wait a minute. Eddie Guerrero. Benoit a bit premature. Eddie Guerrero cuts him off with the pass.
That was not it. I can't believe he said that's it. It wasn't it.
Well, look at that. Superplex. Top rope. And Guerrero took plenty out of himself as well as both men thundered to the canvas.
Oh, I tell you what. Look at this.
Oh, yeah.
The giant killer.
His new buddy. Chris Benoit's new buddy, Shane McMahon. Nice to see Shane. What's he doing out here?
Well, wait a minute. He's not out here. He's in there.
Wait a minute. Shane McMahon and Earl Hebner got into it on Monday night. Shane doing? Sneaking around.
Looking.
Wait a minute.
Oh,
oh. Yeah. Shane just grabbed the leg of Chyna and she bounced off the apron. Oh,
no.
Oh,
Guerrero.
Kick. Shane McMahon into the announce
table.
Guerrero and Benoit going at it. Inside the ring. Wait a minute. Benoit trying to lock it in.
Get it.
And he's got it locked in. Triple across face.
Disqualification.
Locked in.
Chyna and Eddie Guerrero.
Guerrero made it to the ropes, but this rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit.
Oh, wait a minute.
Yes. Benoit's got Hebner. He's got Hebner.
Yes.
Look at the top guy now, King.
Oh, wait a minute. This has been well deserved. This has been a long time coming.
Mean. Benoit's real tough here. The cross face on a referee.
Look at Benoit.
This is ridiculous. What is Benoit doing?
What do you mean, what is he doing? Did you see? It's the crippler crossface.
Look at Shane McMahon, the cheerleader.
He's being executed to professional.
Wait a minute. The Rock.
The Rock.
Shane. The Rock stopped Shane.
Oh, my God.
The Rock stopped Shane.
Yeah.
The Rock stopped Benoit.
Yeah.
Right-handed Benoit. The Rock stopped Benoit.
Get away.
The Rock would have picked Benoit apart.
What is that match?
Spinebuster.
And Christian.
Rock bottom. The tag champions. Shane and Benoit! A spinebuster! A rock bottom! The Rock rocks Benoit!
The Rock has come in and laid the smackdown on Benoit! And Shane! The edge of Christian!
Benoit so bad! He can taste it! Rock bottom edge! The tag team champions have been decimated by the people's champ!
Come on, Rock! You can't do the tag team champions that way! Look at this! He sent a message to Benoit.
Rock, I would imagine you've had all you can stomach of the rabid Wolverine. And
Chris Benoit, it's as simple as this. After running from The Rock, after attacking The Rock from behind like a coward, The Rock has come to one simple conclusion, and that is you are not the most technical wrestler in the WWF. You are not the rabid Wolverine, but what you are is without a shadow of a doubt the biggest chicken The Rock has ever seen.
Whoa. I can't believe that.
That's why Chris Benoit, in 10 days, at Fully Loaded, despite the fact you didn't get the job done on Monday night, The Rock is still putting his WWF title on the line. Not because you've earned it, not because you deserve it, but because, quite frankly, Chris Benoit, you've made it personal.
Rock Benoit at Fully Loaded.
That's why at Fully Loaded, Chris Benoit, The Rock is personally gonna give you the beating of a lifetime. And as a special added bonus, The Rock is gonna take his boot. No, take both his boots, turn them some sideways, and stick them straight up. You're candy.
Okay.
If you smell.
Baby, scream! I can't smell what you're cooking now, Rock. I can't smell what you're cooking. No, no, but you know I can't hear you, Rock. What's that? I can't hear you. I can't. Oh, but you know what? I know what you're thinking, Rocky. That's it. I know what you're thinking, Rock. You're thinking, no. I'm starting to get that whiff. I'm starting to get that vibe, Rock. I know that you can smell that Chris Benoit will be the next World Wrestling Federation champion. What do you think about that, Rock? Yeah!
Oh my gosh!
Yeah.
Look at this! Now finally, they're trying to poke Chris Benoit off the Rock. Benoit is taking out the Rock King. Benoit from behind is taking out the Rock.
Now, Mick, seeing as you're in the mood to give the people what they want, the people's champ has a one-word request. No, a one-word demand. Benoit.
Oh, boy. He would see tonight. He wants Benoit tonight. Man.
Well, The Rock already knows that in 6 days at Fully Loaded, he's got Benoit for the WWF title. But considering how The Rock feels tonight, The Rock says it's going to be The Rock Benoit WWF title match tonight.
See that? Wow. Oh.
And The Rock is demanding that.
He'll fall like paper.
Wait a second, Rock. I guess I see a growing trend here. As much as I'd like to see that match happen tonight.
Oh, my gosh.
Got nothing to lose and everything to gain.
Let's look at what I've done to you over the past several weeks.
Yeah, think about this.
Every time I put you in the crossface.
He's laughing.
I love to hear The Rock squeal! Squeal, Rock!
Oh my gosh. Rock's not laughing.
Whether I win the title tonight or Sunday, one way or another, you will submit and tap out because I'm the greatest technical wrestler in the WWF today.
Probably ever.
And I will be the next WWF champion. Prove me wrong, Rock.
Rock, it doesn't matter if it's tonight.
Oh, no.
Or if it's this Sunday and Fully Loaded.
It doesn't matter.
Because you are looking at the next World Wrestling Federation champion in Chris Benoit. If you smell!
Wait. Hold on a second there, sport. You don't rip off The Rock's catchphrases.
Huh?
Only I can rip off The Rock's catchphrases.
Oh, boy.
It just doesn't sound cool when you do it. So get the picture straight, Shane. I call the shots around here, not you. I make the matches, not you.
Drop the power.
Let me put it this way, Shino. Think of it this way. I'm Tony Soprano, and you're the guy who cleans the toilets at the Bada Bing. Understand?
Bada Bing!
Well, look, I can't help but notice that you brought your three Canadian friends out here with you, didn't you? How are you doing, guys?
Hey.
Thank you for asking.
You guys have been sick and
because
hurt.
Because we're feeling totally better, Mick.
You know, not ready to defend our titles better, but we're better nonetheless.
Not 100% probably.
So you're not ready to defend those titles, huh? Guys, there were a lot of times during my career where I may have had a case of the sniffles or a bad back and didn't feel like wrestling, but I always did. And do you know why? Because I had something, and still do, that apparently you two gentlemen lack, that being a set of testicles.
What? I thought he was gonna say brain damage. Get their testicles.
There you are, you little rascals.
Oh no, he looked at him.
But you know what, I understand you don't feel like you can defend the tag team belts, but I kinda wanna give the fans here a little preview of the tag team match against the Acolytes.
JR, you know this is not right.
That you will have at Fully Loaded. So what I'm gonna do is book for us right here in this very ring tonight a six-man tag team championship match.
What?
A six-man match pitting the two of you and Chris Benoit against the Acolytes.
Oh no.
And their partner, The Rock.
The Rock, the Acolytes, Benoit, the tag champions. Six-man action tonight.
I don't think Benoit liked that.
Well, that's just fine with me, because tonight is just going to be a sampling of what's going to happen at Fully Loaded.
A sample?
Well, Chris Benoit, The Rock says this. How about he come up there and give you a sample ass-kicking all over Albany?
Get out!
Rock came for Benoit. He got him with a steel chair. But where did Benoit go? Oh, there. Uh-oh, Benoit's bleeding. Benoit's been busted open. And here comes a Rock again. A Rock has snapped him. Oh, no. Restrain the Rock!
Stopping the last of the Rock!
Oh, the Rock's eyes! He doesn't even look like the same person!
Come on, Rock.
Oh, watch out.
Rock going now. Benoit's been busted open at the hands
of
the...
Wait a minute! He's got that chair again, JR!
Rock's got that chair, yes he does. That weapon again.
Somebody's gonna have to stop the Rock here!
King, I've never seen the Rock in this moment in my life.
Watch it, watch it.
I mean, the Rock is maniacal.
Benoit!
I mean,
Benoit!
It's obvious the Rock just wants to destroy Benoit.
Get him out of there, Shane.
What? Turn the Cucolani.
Shane and Matt turn to...
We have Benoit.
To get Benoit to safety.
Shane, he's coming. Rock, coming.
Well, Benoit's losing a lot of blood here. He can hardly stand.
From the Rock's attack on Raw Monday night.
Before you were interrupted, I believe you were talking about what a lousy commissioner you've been.
Yeah, that's what he said.
I spent some time thinking about that this week. When on Monday, after the Rock attacked me from behind, after my match, I'm being the kind of person that he is. Smash me in the face with a chair.
Well, Benoit's attacked the Rock from behind on a number of occasions.
Then for the second time, after attacking me from behind with a chair and bringing me on top of the limo, being the piece of crap that he is, gave me the Rock bottom.
King Benoit has a case of selective memory.
What are you talking about? You didn't see that happen? I did.
See, those are the kind of gutless acts the Rock has to resort to against the greatest technical wrestler in the WWF. See, the Rock needs weapons and chairs. All I need are my hands. No. All I need is the crossface. Say, Jericho, you happen to remember the crossface, don't you?
He should.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Last time I had you in the crossface, you passed out from the pain. So no, you probably don't remember the crossface.
I do. I remember it like it was yesterday. Jericho went out like a baby.
Congratulations on your first intelligent and fair decision here in the World Wrestling Federation as its commissioner.
Yes, congratulations, Mick.
You see, Mick, by putting the WWF Championship on the line this Sunday at Fully Loaded via the special disqualification stipulation, you have, in effect, taken away the Rock's avenue of escape, because the Rock knows he cannot beat Chris Benoit on his own.
What?
I know The Rock cannot beat Chris Benoit on his own. And more importantly, Mick, the people know that The Rock cannot beat Chris Benoit on his own.
The Rock's the one who challenged Benoit in the first place.
Yeah, but this special stipulation. Foley's so stupid, he don't even realize what he's done.
Uh-oh.
So, Mick, since you're on a roll with great decisions here, how about tonight you make another one as commissioner?
Oh, boy.
How about tonight in this very ring, Chris Benoit goes one-on-one with the great one himself.
Tonight? What?
And how about, let's let it be for the WWF Championship.
Well,
however, Mick, just like this Sunday at Fully Loaded, let's throw in that special disqualification stipulation. So if, when The Rock is disqualified, Chris Benoit will walk out of here tonight the new World Wrestling Federation Champion.
You got any problem with that, Michael Cole? That's a great idea.
Well, it's up to Commissioner Mick Foley.
Son Mike back. Thank you for letting us come back.
Hey, Mike.
And thank you. Thank you so much for getting us the Rock's autograph tonight.
Nut doesn't fall very far from the tree that does it, huh?
Can I have your autograph?
Yeah, I already gave one to your old man, huh? Don't get greedy there, kid. No. You guys know Howard Finkel?
How you doing?
Hi, how are you?
You remember him, right?
Yes.
When you were a kid, you probably watched him. Howard's like the first guy here or something like that. Listen, I can get you the Rock's autograph. But here's the thing. If I ask Rock for it, he doesn't like me very much. He's probably not going to want to do it.
Okay.
So, Howard is a man for the job. Howard can get it done for you. All right, so what Howard's gonna do, Howard, why don't you take these guys over to like the production office,
right,
where nobody is, and then go get Rock. Rock never refuses an autograph. Great. It might take him a little while because he's looking in the mirror and stuff like that. Howard can get it for
fantastic.
You.
Thank you so much.
Right.
Thank you.
Hey, no problem. Guys, he's gonna do it. He'll
thank
deliver
you.
It. There's no
time.
Question. Come with me, we'll go to the production office
it's
right
great.
Now.
Great.
It's gonna be easy.
Michael, you're definitely gonna get that autograph, believe me, because The Rock is a man of his word. He says he's going to be here. He'll be here. It might take him a few minutes, but trust me, he's definitely going to be here to give you that autograph.
Really appreciate it.
How you doing, man?
Hi, Rock.
Good to meet you.
You too.
What's your name?
Michael.
Michael, it's good to meet you.
My son, Rock. You get an autograph, please.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Thanks a lot.
I told you, the game's a good guy, and Rock's a nice guy, too. Chris Benoit. Oh my gosh, Shane McMahon. Chris Benoit attacking the Rock from behind again. Now the crescent crossface on the Rock.
I know you're feeling the pain. I know you're feeling helpless. I know you're feeling helpless, Rock. I know you're feeling the WWF Championship slip out of your hands to that man, Chris Benoit, the new World Wrestling Federation Champion.
That looks like it hurt.
Oh, that's hurt.
Get your autograph, kid.
Yeah.
Stay
in there. Oh, I owe you. That's it. Cinch it in. Feel it, Rock. Feel scared. I know you're feeling scared. That's it. Cinch it in, Chris. That's it. Harder. Let me hear it. Yes. Come on.
Finally, officials in there to try to rip Chris Benoit off the Rock. What a play. The game is up to the Rock.
That's it, Rock.
What has it done to the Rock King? Another sneak attack from behind by Chris Benoit. Benoit's pushing Rock over the edge.